Hello everybody, it's Tommy and welcome back to another video. Today we are going to be doing a speed build for the Disney save, which is pretty much the only thing that I really want to do in The Sims right now. If I'm opening The Sims currently, it's probably because I'm working on something from the Disney save. And I actually have a few videos on backlog right now that I have been working on behind the scenes. Those of you who are part of my Patreon for the Disney save know that I have quite a few things that I have already completed, and some of them are even available on the gallery. I try to line them up when I'm actually going to be releasing a video, but because of everything that's been going on, I actually haven't been able to put videos out. Probably a lot of you have noticed, some of you may have not, but I haven't been able to do voiceovers for any of my videos. I can get literally every single other piece done, but when it comes to voiceovers, there's just too many people home right now, and it creates some really, really bad audio. Dogs barking, neighbors mowing the lawn, people doing things in their home because everybody's home, as they should be right now. So it's just making this situation for me a little bit harder as far as getting content out. However, I managed to record a few videos, and if you notice that there is a little bit of an audio difference in today's video and probably the next few, that's because there probably is. So basically, I have had to, in order to get like the cleanest audio possible, I've had to resort to recording audio from my car. And I know that that probably sounds really funny to most of you, but I actually used to do this very early on in the beginning of my Sims channel when I had a similar issue. I just could not get clean audio literally anywhere, so I would often just go in my car and kind of park in like a really nice spot and just do some clean audio there where there's like no background noise or distractions. So that's what I've sort of resorted to at this point. Hopefully it won't be something that has to be done all the time, but if it causes a delay in videos, you guys know why. Just know that I'm probably working on the Disney save and I'm trying to get everything going as much as I possibly can, but until this whole situation with the entire world is over, it's probably going to be very hit or miss as far as uploading videos, and I super apologize, but yeah, I have had to cut back. I'm probably only uploading twice or so per week if we're lucky, but even last week I just could not get a video out. So again, I apologize, but just know I'm probably working on the Disney save, and I'm hoping that this whole situation calms down really soon so that we can get back to normal, back on schedule, and everybody is staying super safe and healthy, and everybody is doing okay as well. As far as today's build goes, so yes, this is a Disney save build, and this is actually our first museum of the save. So I don't really like building museums, and it's probably not a big surprise that they are just not the most entertaining lot, in my opinion. There's some people I probably love the museums. However, I just find them to be, like, if I'm gonna play, it's probably not my top priority to go and visit a museum. But as a part of the save, I really did want to include every lot type, and there's already a museum located on this little strip over here where I have kind of been trying to finish out the section. So I decided it was probably a really good spot to fit in a very small museum, and it's probably going to be one of very few in the save. I have an idea for one more, but this one ended up working out really well for a few reasons. So first of all, most of, if not all of, Willow Creek so far has been based after New Orleans or Louisiana, if you're giving like more of a general area. And that is going to be one of the most historical, I would say, places that will be a part of the save, considering that it's an actual location. Whereas if we were going to do like Arendelle, Arendelle has its own history, but it's not exactly like a real place. So I was thinking that it would probably be a really good opportunity to bring in some of the classic like Louisiana culture and history. And Louisiana is obviously known for food, architecture, jazz music, Mardi Gras, a lot of spiritual stuff, and just so much history in Louisiana. So it feels like a really appropriate place to do a museum, and I had the idea to do the museum out of like a very classic style architecture Louisiana home. So this I have built so many times. I can't even tell you. This is probably my fourth time doing a classic Louisiana style home, and it's actually because once, a very long time ago now, I think it's actually been almost a year since I've done one, I used to have a state building series, and one of the first states that I ended up doing was Louisiana. So I got to study the architecture quite a bit and get a feel for like what a traditional home Obviously, things that are a little bit more historic, things that have been there for a long time. Not necessarily like a modern home for Louisiana. Obviously, it can be a lot different. But if we're going for like a classic Louisiana style home, this is probably my fourth one that I have done. So this is based after a real photo. That is why I was attempting to make the orange and the green work in the beginning of the video, because the reference was actually an orange building, but it really kind of stood out on the strip in a way that I didn't like, and it was just a little bit too much. Probably was really nice for the area that the actual building was in, but as far as for doing it for this save, it was maybe just a little too much. Didn't go with like a lot of the other buildings and the flow of the entire area. Like Willow Creek so far is almost 99% Louisiana mansion townhomes, shotgun houses, and factories, factory converted buildings, that type of stuff. And I really like the flow of everything. So I'm trying to keep it very cohesive and make everything look nice, especially from a distance. I'm also going to do a tour of Willow Creek when we are done. So I think we have maybe 5 or 6 more lots that I have to do, and then I'll do an overview of everything that I've done as far as changes go, because since some of the videos have come out, I've corrected some mistakes, maybe updated some lots, done some changes and all of that, and just go over everything so you can see the flow, see what I was kind of going for. Hopefully I hit the vibe just right, and yeah, so you can expect that probably towards the end of when Willow Creek is done, and then we will start the next world for the Disney save, which I'm really excited because I have definitely been overdoing it with, you know, just in general doing like these style of homes. I definitely am in the mood to build something a little bit different. So exciting for me, but also I've got a couple of more exciting things along the way. We've got a nightclub coming. We've got a pub, a couple of more residentials. Last minute, my patrons helped me design an idea for a nightclub that, again, is going to have a very, like, Bayou Louisiana vibe. It's going to be cool. So that as well. And then a couple of more side characters. We've got some Princess and the Frog characters, the Rescuers, which is also featured in the museum here. So the museum, I decided it was going to be a mix of things that are historic to the area. So we've got some representation for like cuisine, Mardi Gras, as much as possible with like the things that we have in game to actually represent that type of stuff. Just history pieces in general, lots of sculptures, anything that looked like it was really historic and could fit into a museum. And then I wanted it to feel like it was obviously a part of the save. It's not going to be just like some random museum. So I decided to have some areas that were dedicated to the various movies that take place in Willow Creek. So that would be The Princess and the Frog, and then we have The Rescuers. So up until this point, The Rescuers has actually not been featured in the build in any of Willow Creek at all. And I would say it's one, because I didn't know The Rescuers took place in Louisiana. And then I sat down and watched it, and I was trying to come up with what I could actually include to integrate it into the whole save. And most of the movie takes place between New York City and Louisiana, so it was a little bit hard to figure out what am I actually going to use. And ultimately, I did find one thing that I'm going to use, and that's going to be a nightclub way later on. But as far as like characters go and doing some of that stuff, it really didn't fit. There wasn't enough information there to like do an entire build off of. However, I thought it would be kind of cool if we had a piece of the museum that was at least dedicated to it. And what came to mind right away was Penny's discovery of the Devil's Eye. So if you haven't seen the movie, or it's been a really long time since you've seen The Rescuers, there is a little girl named Penny, and basically she is abducted. It's like really dark, actually. And she is taken so that she can help this lady find the Devil's Eye, which is like a little, it's not little at all. It's a huge purpley blue stone, like a diamond, essentially. And it's kind of a long story, obviously, as to why she is the one chosen to help and everything. But I thought it would be cool, since that was actually discovered in Louisiana as per the story, to have a section of the museum that was dedicated to the Devil's Eye, to her discovery of it, and really just feature Penny, because she was a really cool character, and I was very surprised I quickly got attached to her. She's very like spunky and brave, and even though she's a child in a really bad situation in the movie, she is super brave and super intelligent and really holds her own. So I thought that that was cool, and I wanted to represent her in some kind of way, hopefully maybe as a character later on in the save, but you never really know as things kind of develop as we go through everything and what I'm going to have room for and all of that stuff. So in the corner where that little bump out is, I do have like this big purpley stone, and that's supposed to represent the devil's eye. We don't really have like a dedicated huge diamond, which would have been really cool and super perfect. And then we have a well with a bucket, which is actually how she gets into the tunnel that actually leads her to discover it and everything. So I thought that was cool. And actually at the end of the movie, they do say that it was donated to a museum. I think they actually specify that it was donated to the Smithsonian possibly, but we're just going to change that a little bit to fit into the save. So that's my little rescuers area. I didn't want to feature any of the other characters because they really were just miserable, horrible characters. Not horribly written, but just horrible people. And so obviously I don't want to feature them as like a awesome thing in a museum where they get like their own dedicated area. It doesn't seem appropriate for what would actually be done. And then everything surrounding is just anything I felt like could fit really cool or appropriate for the area. So some shout outs to like some food, a steamboat, and any kind of like steamboat in general, just boats. Obviously very Louisiana, and you even I think there's scenes in The Princess and the Frog where they're on a steamboat. So again, a little bit of a shout out there. You do have to include an easel, which I was very annoyed about. Because I don't know why. I don't know that I've ever been to a museum in real life where you would have like all these really nice historical pieces and then they just have an easel in the corner that you would go over and start painting your own thing. It just doesn't seem super realistic to me. I get it, they probably want to give your Sims something to do a little bit more so than like go and view items, but I don't know, felt out of place to me, but it is something that you have to include. So just trying to fill up the area a little bit with some different pieces. I tried to really, really think about everything that went in. It's not supposed to be random. Like everything I included was supposed to be like, this feels like something that would really fit in this museum. And plants and stuff too. I thought that that would be a really cool way to feature like some of the surrounding area, because we've got the bayou, we've got like lots of plants, we've got lots of wildlife. And one of the things that I included with Princess Tiana is that she is like a wildlife rehabilitationist or expert, and she really gets into the protection of the bayous and the wildlife and all of that as like a little side thing about her character. So I thought it would be cool to feature some of that stuff, but it's actually going to go upstairs because this is a two level and we had like some room upstairs obviously, so we're gonna do that. I did also do a desk in the front here. Realistically, if you were gonna go to a museum, you would probably walk up to a desk and pay to get in. A lot of them are free, they can be free, but you'll usually have to check in with somebody. And I've even been to museums where like you have to check in with a person because that person is going to walk you through the museum, because you're not allowed to get like within a certain amount of feet of certain items and things like that. So they have like a person that's assigned to bring you around and tour you through the whole thing. So there is a designated check-in area for that and like a little gated off space where you would enter. And obviously the Sims mechanics, it's not going to generate anybody to sit at that desk. I think in fact nobody actually works at museums. Like you can just kind of come and go, very similar to a library, but I felt like it was still appropriate to have that in the area where you would enter the building, and it felt like it really fit. And then moving upstairs, so this is where it does get a little bit more complicated for the museum. So recently the Sims decided to update and they added a really, really weird thing that I super don't agree with and I'm very frustrated by. So basically, the most recent update to The Sims, it made it so that you can no longer take a painting that is like from a different lot and move it to a new lot and use that painting to upload to the gallery without it getting marked as custom content. So when I started this museum, I knew I wanted to have an area dedicated to Big Daddy, because Big Daddy is like the town celebrity, and it's kind of funny that he's always nominated as like the Mardi Gras King, and he's probably got all of these awards. Everybody really loves him. And then I figured that if a prince and princess lived in the area, there might be a little bit of history there. You might want to include, like, the princess and the prince, some photos of them, a painting or two, and some stuff about Meldonia, I believe, is the kingdom that Naveen is from. So I wanted to have all of that stuff, and I knew I was going to, like, make custom paintings and then move them in here. So it very much felt like it was something that was a part of the save, and also I get to include my own characters in an interesting way. But like I said, they just updated The Sims and they made it so that if you do this, it gets marked as containing custom content. I don't know why they made this decision. I 100% do not agree with it. I think it is a really weird choice, and one of my favorite things to do used to be go on the gallery and find custom paintings that people had done in their game and then put them in my builds so that I had an even bigger variety as far as paintings go. Because it can get a little bit repetitive, especially if I'm trying to do something very specific like this, where I want to include certain characters and things. It's just nice to have portraits available. So I did have to go to the various lots and get paintings done of the characters I wanted to include, including Tiana, Naveen, and then we have Big Daddy as like a big feature in the museum, but it marks it as custom content. So it's a really, really big problem. According to the patch notes, it's not actually supposed to work like that. It's supposed to be only like custom paintings that are painted by looking at a different lot. It's a very complicated thing, but rest assured, this actually got marked on the gallery as containing custom content, and I'm very, very frustrated by it. So if you're looking for this on the gallery, there are two versions. There's one without CC and there is one with CC. Neither of them actually have CC, but if you want to have the version that contains the custom paintings of Tiana and Naveen and Big Daddy, you will have to look for the custom content version of this. If you're going to wait until we have the whole save completed, and you're not downloading lots per video as they come out, then this won't be an issue. It'll just automatically go into your game normally and we will have no problems. But I just wanted to warn those of you who are downloading one by one and taking things off of the gallery, you're gonna have a hard time finding this one if you don't check with custom content. I did upload a different version of it that doesn't have the CC mark on it, but it doesn't include the paintings. They've been replaced, I think, with some stuff from vampires, so just keep that in mind when you're looking on the gallery. As well as if you're looking for my different versions of Sims, I tend to upload versions with eyelashes and without eyelashes, and then obviously one gets marked as having CC and one does not. So that is a really complicated mess, and I'm really sorry that that's the case. Hopefully, if I read the patch notes correctly, that's not how it's supposed to work. So hopefully they fix it soon, or I can fix it in some kind of way. But I don't know. Always be checking the gallery. If a lot is not uploaded from the Disney save, it's probably because I'm having some kind of an issue getting it working or getting it to fully update without custom content, because sometimes my builds just get marked as containing CC, even though I haven't built with custom content for years now. So keep an eye out. I actually did upload quite a few things recently and fixed some lots and updated some stuff. You'll always know it's updated because I put in big letters at the beginning of the bio that it's been updated. So I've re-uploaded some lots if you're looking for anything from the Disney save so far. And I actually think that is going to be most of the build here. So yeah, last little areas upstairs dedicated to some Louisiana wildlife, a little bit, a couple more sculptures, some plants, some fish, and then the two areas that are dedicated to our princess and prince, and then good old Big Daddy. So that is going to be today's build. I hope you guys enjoyed. Stay tuned for a couple of more Disney saves. And I am so sorry for the audio change. Hopefully everything goes back soon. Let me know what you thought of today's build. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more. Hit that little bell icon below to turn on post notifications so you can get updated every single time I post. And I will talk to you all in the next one.